Hello everybody, and welcome back to a brand new video. We just hit 44,000 subscribers. Please like this video down below and subscribe to this channel. Can we get to 45K at the end of the month? That will be our next milestone. But first, I have to tell you guys about my friends over at Noble Gold. Gold just made history. It hit its record high of $1,933.30 and is showing no signs of stopping. Bloomberg said it will zoom past $2,000 sooner than expected, and Bank of America said it will get to $3,000 in 18 months. Billionaire Thomas Kaplan predicted a new decade-long bull market that will push past $5,000 an ounce. Silver is joining the rally too. It jumped 4.5% to its highest since 2013 at $23.86 per ounce. This is no surprise to the team Noble Gold, but if it's a surprise to you and you're sick of the low returns, hassle, and volatility of stocks, it's time you look at gold and silver. The team at Noble Gold will find you a perfect plan that works. Choose precious metals for your IRA or 401k this month, and you may even get a free 5-ounce silver America the Beautiful coin. This offer is for qualified IRAs and 401k, so please call 877-646-5347 to see if you qualify for this amazing offer. Stop wasting your time, stop losing opportunities for gains, and protect your future. Go to noblegoldinvestments.com. Again, that's noblegoldinvestments.com. And today I want to take a look at the 2020 presidential election map. Right here is exactly where it stands based off of polling data alone. These are not my predictions. I have moved Ohio from the blue to the red column based off of a very old Rasmussen poll with terrible methodology that probably shouldn't be in the aggregate. And it actually showed Trump doing better in Pennsylvania than Ohio. It's very iffy stuff. We know how early Ohio polling is. Not really the most accurate, especially if you look at 2018, 2016, etc. But the bottom line here is that Donald Trump is closer to winning this election than it really looks like. If you look at the state of Florida, there was a poll that came out today. The poll actually had a left-leaning bias in 2018, despite the fact it technically is a Republican-aligned poll. It had a tied ball game. In Arizona, where Trump just rallied today, the poll showed Trump up by 3 points. And this was all pre-Kamala and pre-the DNC, which is an absolute disaster so far. I mean, it could change. But Biden's not getting a bump out of that one night. If anything, you might even see a decline. Even you see people on the left like Kyle Kulinski, David Pakman, Charles Blow, Marianne Williamson all trashing the DNC, and their viewership rate was roughly around half, if not lower, than their 2016 viewership rate. But if you look at this map right now, Republicans are closer than they really would appear. Obviously, you could look at a state like Florida. If Florida and Arizona flips, that's a 260 firewall. He just needs to win one of the new core four. People always say the core four of Ohio, North Carolina, Florida, and Iowa. I don't think that those are really the core four states anymore. I think that they're going to be Minnesota, Wisconsin, Michigan, and Pennsylvania. Maybe a throw in New Hampshire in there if Trump gets lucky this November or something like that. But make no mistake, those are going to be the competitive states. So Trump is closer than expected. And I really do think he'll win Florida. I think we'll have a little bit more insight after tonight's primary. I don't expect Republicans to necessarily beat the Democrats in primary turnout, but it's going to be very close either way. It's going to be very interesting. And I think it's a state that's going to go down the wire. I think Trump will have the edge come November. But in terms of the state of Arizona, if Trump loses Arizona, we could look at this map here and we could say Trump loses Arizona and he very well could end up winning Pennsylvania. And then what would happen? We're at a 269 to 269 tie that would assume he would hold Nebraska second. Or you could see an election where Trump would lose Nebraska second. He would lose Pennsylvania, but he would win Arizona and he would win Wisconsin. This is also a very plausible election map. Personally, if you look at the primary turnout in Nebraska second, fairly decent for Republicans. They held it in 2018 by all metrics. So the bottom line here is that this election could very plausibly end in a tie. And we see this here. Trump flips two states off of the current average, Florida and Pennsylvania. And a lot of polling in Pennsylvania shows Republicans lagging a little bit behind, and that's okay. But if this was the map, obviously, assuming Trump would win Nebraska's second district, then Donald Trump would be tied with Joe Biden. And would this be enough to win? A lot of people are saying, wait a minute, it goes to the House. The election would go to the House if it's 269 to 269. And this is very true. But the bottom line is it's not one representative per vote. If that was the case, the Democrats would win the presidency here. But the bottom line is that's not exactly how it's done. If you want to look at this state delegations map, this is currently what it is right now. I put it on the governor's map because it was the only map in Yappa Mess that would let me have one vote per state. Now, Republicans currently hold 26 delegations. Democrats hold 23. One delegation is split. That's Pennsylvania. Split delegations do not vote. They vote as a delegation. Under this structure right here, Donald Trump would win the election in a 269 to 269 tie, assuming that no faithless electors would defect from Trump to Biden in this scenario. So you look at this map right here, Republicans are at 26, Democrats are at 23. Now, things can change. Personally, I think that if you look at Michigan, at the very least, Amash will be gone. Meyer will most likely replace him. So Republicans will have an even bigger lead. And if Republicans manage to get leads in Minnesota and Iowa, assuming they would flip the Colin Peterson seat and the open seat in Iowa second, then Republicans would have a 6-vote lead over the Democrats, and Trump would win this election not by an electoral college margin necessarily. He would win it 26-20. And it's possible the Dems could, if they have a really good year, flip some other, you know, delegations in the process. I really can't see them flipping Florida's if Trump is going to win Florida, which I think it's a must-win for him. I think he knows he has to win it to win. It is his home state after all. But the bottom line is this election very well could go down the wire to his 269-269 tie. And the bottom line here is that if it does go to the state delegations, it's not 270 to win. They always say 270 to win. It's not. It's 269 to win. By and large, 269 to win, even if no delegation changes. Obviously, Michigan's will go to a split district at a very minimum. Maybe Republicans can out of nowhere flip Connor Lamb's seat or something like that in Pennsylvania, and they will gain a delegation or something like that. Republicans could do better than this. Democrats could do better than this. But there is a very, very little chance that the Democrats actually are going to be able to make up those 4 net delegations, especially because split delegations cannot vote in this type of election result. So it's very interesting to analyze this stuff. And the number to win, I'm telling people, it's actually 269. So the Trump campaign very well could go all out on Florida and all out in Pennsylvania in a strategy to win if it really has to come down to that. Because you look at the polls, Trump is solidifying himself in Texas, Trump up in Texas, Trump up in Iowa, Trump up in Ohio, Trump up in North Carolina. Maybe Florida could get closer. Arizona, I think after the Harris pick, it doesn't bode too well in the Sun Belt. We don't have any new polling out of Arizona. We don't have any new polling out of Florida. But the fact that the poll out of the Heritage Foundation, which again is a Republican-aligned poll, despite the fact that they overestimated the Dems in 2018, it's very, very telling, and it's a good sign that Republicans are up by 3 points in Arizona. Do I think Trump's going to win by 3? No, he's probably going to win by like 1, but I do think he'll hold Arizona. I think he will hold Florida. And at that rate, he could probably go for one of the Rust Belt states. In fact, that's really where he should be spending a lot of his time. This election is going to come down to Michigan, Wisconsin, Pennsylvania, Minnesota. Throw Arizona in the mix as well. And we're going to see exactly what happens. But a 269 to 269 tie very may well happen. And if it does happen, Donald Trump will benefit the most of it. So Trump needs 269 to win. And Biden needs to win 270 to win this election for all intents and purposes. So it's going to be interesting to see how it shakes out. But like I said, this would be a wild ending to such an already wacky year. So we'll just have to wait and see. But anyways, guys, thanks for watching this video. Please like this video down below. Comment down below and subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell for notifications so you never miss another video. Follow me on social media. Become a member. Donate to the Patreon or Subscribestar links in description. As always, guys, thanks for watching. Red Eagle, out.